So now, once we have actually discussed the clinical presentation of the patient, we need to actually understand how these patients are diagnosed. Now, when these patients have presented in the emergency department or the ICUs, we are to first do the ABC of these patient always. ABC is airway breathing and circulation, where we check whether the patient's airway is compromised, and if the patient's airway is compromised and the Glasgow Coma Scale is less than 9 by 15, we are to pass the endotracheal tube to maintain the airway. We are to check if the patient's breathing is okay or patient have already aspirated any gastric contents into the lungs, then in those cases we need to actually manage it properly. And finally, we are to check the circulation of the patient, because these patients most of the time can be in the atrial fibrillation. So we are to check if the patient has got a normal pulse or irregular pulse. And what about the blood pressure of the patient? If blood pressure is on the lower side and we have actually auscultated the chest, then we are to make a decision whether we are to give fluids or we are to put patient on the inotropic support in cases of the pulmonary edema or any crepitations in the chest. Now, along with all this, we are to definitely check the blood sugar of the patient, because if the blood sugar is less than 50 milligram per deciliter or less than 2.7 millimole per liter, then these patient can present as a hypoglycemia, as with the sign and symptoms of the acute ischemic stroke. So that brings us to close to that stroke mimics. These are the conditions which are not the acute ischemic strokes, but they present more or less like the stroke. So these are the seizures. Seizures happen in 17% of the time. In 17% of the time, it does present as the stroke. In the brain tumor, it's again the 17% of the time it presents like this. In 13% of the time, it presents like the hypoglycemia, presents like stroke, hyponatremia, and encephalopathy, which is uremic, hepatic, and septic. They all can present with the sign and symptoms of the acute ischemic stroke. So we need to take into consideration all of this. So how to diagnose these patients? Once we have taken the history in detail and we have done the physical examination, and now we know that a part of the body is not moving at all, or there is a weakness, like the stroke in evolution, patient has got is able to actually move it up, but there is a weakness. If we are to check the weakness, we should know what is the power of that limb. There are muscle powers. We are to check muscle power, because if someone is able to move the limb properly against any kind of a force, then the power is 5 by 5. If patient is able to actually move against a force but not as normal as the normal limb, then we call the power of the limb 4 by 5. When person is able to lift the limb against the gravity but cannot actually resist any kind of a force, then we give 3 by 5. And those patients who are not able to lift the limb against the gravity, but they just can move it horizontally across the gravity, they are not able to defy the gravity. The power has decreased so much that patient is not able to lift the limb off the bed or against the gravity, we give it 2 by 5. And if patient is not able to move the limb at all and there is only flickering, there is only flicker movement, then we give the power 1 by 5. And if someone is not able to move it at all, we just give 0 by 5. So we check the power of the involved limb, which the patient gave on the history, and we are checking now on the physical examination. And are we know that the patient has got a disturbed conscious level, or is ataxic, or vomiting, or there is another problem, any other focal deficit, then the first thing we do in this patient is the CT scan of the brain. We do the CT scan of the brain. CT, computed tomography. Of brain. in all those patients who either on the history give the suspicion of the acute ischemic stroke, or you check the physical, check the patients through the physical examination, and you develop a suspicion that patient actually has a acute ischemic stroke, and you have excluded the stroke mimics, then the first thing you get in these patient, it is the CT scan of the brain. This is based on the X-ray technique. Based on X-ray techniques. And actually, why we get it? In cases of the acute ischemic stroke, it will be normal. CT brain will be normal. Within the first 24 hours, within first 24 hours of symptom. Then the question arises, why are we getting the CT scan of the brain? The reason we are getting the CT brain is because we want to rule out the hemorrhage. Rule out hemorrhagic stroke. Otherwise, the CT scan of the brain which we obtain within the first 24 hour will be normal. So the reason we are getting this CT brain, it is always very readily available, and it doesn't take more than 5 minutes for the patient to undergo the procedure of getting CT brain. We want to rule out the hemorrhagic stroke at this stage of the management, because whatever medication we use for these patients as a management of the acute ischemic stroke, they will be actually contraindicated in hemorrhagic stroke. The hemorrhagic stroke is very readily visible on the CT brain. If, for example, someone is coming with the nausea and vomiting and weakness of one part of the limb, and there is a strong suspicion of CVR, the stroke, which 15 to 20% of the time can be hemorrhagic stroke, then it will be immediately evident on the CT brain, but there will be no change within the first 24 hour in cases of the ischemic stroke. So we want, at this stage, we want to rule out the hemorrhagic stroke. But if you want to be sure about it, about the development of the acute ischemic stroke, then instead of the CT brain, you should get MRI brain, especially the diffusion weighted images. MRI brain. And the technique should be diffusion weighted. DWI, because on the diffusion weighted images, just after 5 to 10 minutes or within the 30 minutes, there are certain changes in the brain structure which are actually evident on the MRI brain. Which technique? Diffusion weighted images. There will be hyper tense areas, there will be white areas in the MRI brain within the half hour of the development of these sign and symptoms which point towards the acute ischemic stroke. But CT brain will be normal. So why we do not prefer the MRI brain? Because one, this is not available everywhere. This is not as prevalent as the CT brain machines are available. Secondly, it takes around 30 to 45 minutes to complete the MRI brain. And fourthly, there are contraindication for having the MRI brain, because it is contraindicated in those patients who have cardiac pacemaker. Cardiac pacemakers or any implant in the body. That includes the cochlear implant, that also includes the implantable cardioverter defibrillator. So all those patients, they cannot have the MRI, because this is magnetic resonance imaging. It's a magnetic technique, and obviously those patients who have got some metal things, they cannot actually have this MRI brain. Thirdly, those patients who have got a conscious level which is lower than the normal, less than the 9/15, and they have been intubated and there is oxygen source going on, it is very difficult for in majority of the institutions there are no open MRI available, so again there is a limitation to it in most of the patient. So better to obtain CT brain immediately in the first 5, 10 or 15 minutes to just rule out the hemorrhagic stroke, because it will be entirely normal, but there will be symptoms because we have excluded the stroke mimics and we have also excluded the hemorrhagic stroke. The thing which now is there can be acute ischemic stroke. So we are to manage these patients within a certain limited time period, so we cannot waste our time to obtain the MRI brain. But if there is a facility available in the institution where you are managing these patients and there is no contraindication for the MRI brain, like the pacemakers and the implants and cochlear or otherwise, then you should get the diffusion weighted images, because in these images there will be brightening of the area which is involved, and it will happen within the half hour, less than 30 minutes. So you will become very sure of the development of the acute ischemic stroke. Now, along with the CT brain, you can also obtain CT angiogram. And in those patients where you have a very strong suspicion you had obtained the CT brain, in order to localize the artery or the involved which branch of the cerebral vasculature is involved, you should have computed tomography angiography, CT angiogram. CT angiogram, because it does localize the artery which is involved. In order to localize the involved arteries, because there will be a filling defect. Even there are certain MRI images which have the delayed effect, they will show the filling defect that will also confirm the branch of the anterior cerebral or the middle cerebral or the posterior cerebral artery involved in the causing the acute ischemic stroke. So CT angiogram is always very helpful. So what other test can you have? We can have ECG, because sometimes these patients may have atrial fibrillation, and also these patients may have myocardial infarction, and they may be unstable because of the myocardial infarction, so it can also act as a stroke mimic. So along with the CT brain, MRI, CT angiogram, we can also have electrocardiogram to rule out the atrial fibrillation and MI. And if obviously there is a facility, echocardiogram can be done within the minutes. Echocardiogram. So what other tests we may need? There are so many patients actually which are on antithrombotic or antiplatelet agents. In those patients, we need to get CBC, which is complete blood count, plus PT, APTT, INR. Because those patients in whom INR is 1.7 or more, there will be contraindication of the very specific management of the acute ischemic stroke, which we are going to talk later on. So we are to obtain CBC, because there may be thrombocytopenia, because if the platelets are less than 100,000, we cannot give the kind of a treatment which is needed in these cases. If the PT, INR and APTT, they are deranged, or the patient was on some sort of antithrombotic or antiplatelets, then there are chances that these may be deranged, so we'll have to withhold the treatment. So in the lab values, we need to have the CBC, PT, APTT, INR. We need to have ECG, echocardiogram, as the as a workup for the cardiac involvement, or the primary issue may be the cardiac, because sometime after MI these patients are not conscious And so these patients can be the primary category of the myocardial infarction. And obviously, we did talk about the CT brain, CT angiogram and MRI, diffusion weighted imaging. So the most important test in all those patients who are presenting with the with some focal deficit, with the, or any of the symptom pointing towards the acute ischemic stroke, they should have, after the ABC, airway breathing and circulation, they should have CT angiogram immediately. CT scan of the brain, not the angiogram first, of course. CT brain to rule out the hemorrhage, and if there is a possibility of getting MRI to just confirm the diagnosis, because it confirms it within the half hour. So MRI brain diffusion weighted, we don't need to give any contrast. But yes, in cases of the CT angiogram, we will have to use the angiogram to look for the filling defect. And even there are MRI techniques which are delayed defect, so they also show the filling defect. So this is how these patients are diagnosed. And once diagnosed, they then comes the management of these acute ischemic stroke patient, which we are going to talk now.